Hi everybody, I'm Tim from troutandfeather.com, and yes, you read that title correctly. In this fly tying tutorial, we're going to be tying the Micro Mop. Stay tuned. Here's a sneak peek of the finished Micro Mop. Not a lot to this fly, definitely that same mop effectiveness. Hopefully you have fished the mop before. If you haven't fished the Micro Mop, just keep watching. It's a simple one to tie, and then after the tying, we're going to talk about just how effective this fly is and how I like to fish it. Okay, you better pay attention or you are going to miss this one. So this is considered the Micro Mop, and we'll talk a little bit more about this after the tying. But to get this rolling, in my Stonfo Caveman Vise, I have a Honic competition hook. It's the H450BL. It's a jig hook, which means whenever you have it paired with the appropriate slotted bead, it's gonna ride hook point up. So you have less of a chance to snag. On that hook, I have a bead from Hazard Fly Fishing. The bead is a 2.5 millimeter tungsten. It's a matte black bead, and I really like that matte black, especially on smaller size flies, because it's not too obtrusive. Even though this is kind of considered more of one of those flies that's going to be, the fish are going to really see this thing coming, and they really love this style of pattern, this mop pattern. Now I'm going to add my thread first. I'm going to go with an 8-aught black uni thread. I'm really just going to try to jam it right behind that bead, kind of where I would have some wire. I'm not going to add wire to this one because this mop material typically does absorb some water, but if you feel more comfortable adding a little bit, go for it. You can add a little bit more weight. I'm going to push this mop back a little bit. I'm just going to wrap maybe a third of the way down the shank of the hook and then back up. Then I'm going to stop. Now let me explain kind of what you see going on in the video. I've already grabbed a piece of the Ultra Chenille. This color is considered shrimp pink. And what I did with this, I cut it to length, and it's about 1.5 inches right now. It's a little bit longer than normal, but I tend to leave them a little bit longer when I first tie them. Then I tend to kind of cut them down as I begin to fish them. And I just took my fingernails and I stripped off the end of the material, exposing this inner core. It just looks like two strands. Then I simply took this piece, and I'll just kind of point to it right now, and I inserted the point of the hook and I ran it around, so now it's kind of waiting for me at the bend. Now if you watch my first Mop Fly video, I definitely encourage you to do so. That Mop Fly video, it's been a very popular one for me, but that Mop Fly itself has caught me a lot of fish. But there's definitely like a million different ways to accomplish the Mop Fly. Now this is one that I learned about because one of my friends was telling me that Devin Olson ties his and he uses a lot of super glue because it really helps to prevent the mop from kind of fouling around the hook depending on how you tie it in. And I really love that because super glue is something that I probably would have never used 20 years ago, but I have definitely come around to it because it really helps to increase the durability of the fly. So what I'm going to do now is just grab a little bit of super glue. I'm using crazy glue. This is brushable, and I really like these brushable ones. So I'm just taking the brush and I'm just dabbing it around the inside to get a lot of the glue off. I only need just a touch of it. And I'm basically just going to put a little bit of super glue over those thread wraps. Then I'm going to take this Micro Mop material and just bring it forward. So I just have a little bit of a gap right behind the bead. At that point, I'm going to bring my thread around and I want to lock those two fibers in place. So there's four wraps, more than enough. I'm just going to pull them back, get a couple wraps in front. Then I'm going to take my scissors and let's just get rid of those. Now, I won't lie, you can absolutely finish off the fly right now and be done with it, and it will fish fine. I don't prefer that. Instead, I recommend grab your favorite peacock dubbing. Mine's going to be just simple ice dub color peacock by Hairline. Just going to put a little bit in a little dubbing noodle, just enough to kind of cover up that tag, get a little bit more in there. I like this peacock material just kind of going back a hair. I don't want to build it up too much, but I want just enough to kind of fill in that gap. Let's get one more wrap in there. Then I'm going to go right to my whip finish. If you want to put super glue at this point as well, I know there are many tires that do that as well. Sometimes I add some head cement, sometimes nothing. In this case, I really don't feel like adding a little bit more head cement. I'm just going to do two whip finishes, a 5 and a 3. So I got more than enough in there. Let's get rid of our thread. And you can see all those fibers kind of going all over the place. I want some length to them. I don't need a ton. So there is the finished Micro Mop. I'll give you a quick 360 look at it. And now I'll let you know that whenever this sits in my box, it's about this long right here. I know there's some fishermen out there that will actually take matches or some type of a lighter and burn the end, and they feel that they get a little bit more longevity out of it. I'm not disagreeing with that. That's just something I haven't really felt the need to do. But I will tell you, whenever I fish this fly, especially in areas that are really low water, very clear water, keeping it this length is something that I really just don't prefer to do. So I'll take my nippers if I'm on the stream, or I keep some in my box that are already cut down a little bit shorter, about 1.5 or twice as long as the shank of the hook. So that's about as small as I will fish this mop. So anywhere between the length you just saw it and the length that you see it now, those are my ideal lengths. I used to take a little bit of Velcro, kind of brush that stuff out. No more. What you see is what you get. So there's the finished Micro Mop. This is a great one. Let's change the camera angle a little bit and talk more about this fly. There you have it, the Micro Mop, a really fast tie, and again, just another truly effective fly, almost as much, if not more at times, than the original mop. Well, there's a few people that I have to blame for this one. Years ago, as I was fishing the mop fly in the summertime, it really wasn't producing for me, and I kind of blamed it on the size, because the original mop, I would fish it typically around a size 12, and it just seemed a little too large. On some of the mops that I would purchase, there were smaller versions of the mop, but I basically had to shave them down to get more of that Micro Mop that I was searching for, but I really didn't know if it was even out there or if it was just a pipe dream that I was having, until I was at, I believe, the fly fishing show, and I was sitting in a presentation that George Daniel was giving, and at one point during it, he mentioned the Micro Mop. So I knew it was out there, and I had to find the right material. I kind of started experimenting, and I found a couple that worked, but not really that were either that durable or worked as well as I thought they could, until I walked into Holsinger's Fly Shop. It's co-owned by Ron and Sean Holsinger, and we started talking. The notion of the Micro Mop came up, and yes, they had the material for me, and I think they saw sucker written on my face, and they were just telling me, you need this color, and this color, and this color. So Ron and Sean, thank you. I think I now own all of the colors of this material. So the material that I've settled on, it's produced by the Bug Shop out in California. It's called Ultra Chenille, and it says UV Plus. I have a bunch of different colors. I believe the one in the video was Shrimp Pink. I love that color. I think Sean liked it as well. And there are a lot of other colors out there. Experiment and see which color works best for you based on what species you're fishing for. And there's lots of different ways that you can vary it. In the video, you saw me tie it with a black bead. It was a tungsten bead and from Hazard Fly Fishing, and I used dark thread. I believe it was black thread. You can also use more of a UV colored thread or some type of a fluorescent thread if you're going for more of a hot spot. So don't hesitate to do that as well, and just experiment with that. Experiment with the dubbing, and also just have fun with the mop material. I've seen some that were just really, really super long, but people fish those for bass. Try it out. See what works for you, again, based on the species and the water that you're fishing. So now let's jump from fly tying into fishing a little bit, and I've already kind of hinted on how I fish this fly, and I tend to fish this, for trout anyway, during the summertime when there's lower flows and it's also clearer water. That original mop, it's just a little large for, we'll say, small spring creeks, and it just almost doesn't even feel right doing it. But it does still work. However, the Micro Mop just seems to work that much more effective in those two situations. I like it in fast water. I like it in slow water. I fish the mop and now the Micro Mop for warm water species, for trout, for steelhead, you name it. It seems like fish just love this fly. So if you have not yet experimented with the Micro Mop, I'm sorry to burst your bubble. Go out there, find the material that works for you. Maybe check out this stuff. If you get it from Holsinger's, tell them they owe me like 15% or something for mentioning their name in this video. But have fun with it, and truly, I really know that you're gonna catch fish on it. And the one kind of side note that I have to mention, the mop fly is one of those flies, for me anyway, that some days I use it and it's just lights out and the fish just can't resist. And other days, it just can't get a fish at all. So if you've used it once or twice and it didn't work and you kind of tucked it away in your fly box, use it again a few more times. try to vary the situation a little bit because it does work. One of my buddies, Shane, cut smallmouth on the mop fly. Go figure. It's one of those flies that you have to just play around with because fish like it. And if you just saw how easy it was to tie, you should like it too. Well, thanks everyone for watching this fly tying tutorial on the Micro Mop. If you'd like to watch more like this, you can check out my website, which is troutandfeather.com. If you want to sign up for my monthly email list, just scroll to the bottom of the homepage and put in your email address there. You can also find Trout and Feather on Facebook and on Instagram. I'd love to connect with you in those social media accounts too. And speaking of those, thank you so much for all of you who share my videos through your Facebook or Instagram. I truly do appreciate that. It helps my views, whatever that means, but it's great to know that you really like the videos and you share them out with your friends and people in your own social media networks. So I appreciate it. If you have any questions or comments, you can leave them down below in the comments section, or you can email me at tcammisa@gmail.com. And speaking of the original mop, I will put a link to it down below in the description of this video. It's easily one of my more popular videos now. It's a simple tie, but it's one of those flies that people just keep going back to, hence why I have so many video views on that one. Well, once again, thank you everyone so much for watching this video, and I'll see all of you next time.